Thank you, Dr. Rajendra, Dr. Neeta Ben, Madhav, Dr. Sood. We have dignitaries who are present here, and I'm happy to share whatever little work we have done over a period of last 30 years, especially into telemedicine for last 3 years. Dr. Rajendra did my 90% of the talking, so I'm happy, and I'm also happy that I'll be able to share with you what has transpired in last few years. You know, he has been talking about the data, evidences, a model which works, and model which can be implemented and which has been implemented. So I'm going to make his life and his next 5 years very comfortable. That's my vision. What is our purpose? What is our passion? What is our mission? We keep on hearing health for all by 2015. We need help. Help from these people to make it possible. And I'm sure we will get it. This one for the chairman. No, topi pen ke achha kaam kare. How to make this, you know, unreachable reality? And that is what we did. We are talking of statistics. Here are 14,238 patients which were seen in 1 year, and the only amount which they had paid was 1,83,000. And these patients were seen with the help of homeopathy. I'll share all the details possible. Let us understand what is the power of telehomeopathy, and I'll be sharing with you some of the success stories, small and quick ones. He was talking about chronic cases. Here we have treated thousands of acute and chronic cases with excellent result. You can see a case of eczema being treated and everything has come under control. Again, a case where total proliferation of the skin has happened, and now you can see after the treatment it is under control. Same way, psoriatic patch or eczematous patch, which comes under control, and you can see a growth which has disappeared. Now these are all evidence based. Rajendra has been talking, give us evidence. Here is the evidence. We have treated thousands of patients with excellent result and with just minimum expenses. Now how that, and you know, Dr. Kishan said beautifully that it has to be an Indian model. We cannot copy American or European or a Swiss model in India. It is not going to work, friends. You know, look at the infrastructure they have. Look at the roads they have. Here, you know, we conducted some telemedicine van, went into the village, and what happened? The antenna fell down. Because why? One of the tree branch touched it and it fell down. It cannot work. The same model what is in Europe. And Europe, look at the population. Here, 75% of the people do not get the basic facility. They have to travel. As Rajendra said, you know, how much of money is spent in their traveling to get the basic fee, you know, facility. So we have to have an Indian model which takes care of the infrastructure, the roads and reachability, the population, the budget constraint, and the literacy rate. Rajendra, you have got 55,000 crores. Give me 500 crores and I give you guarantee that it will reach to every Indian at least the basic healthcare facilities. What is a simple mobile application? He was talking of mobile application. That is the future, and that is what we want to penetrate into. You can have for acute conditions, you can have for eye care, you can have for pediatrics, you can have for veterinary. Very simple thing. You know, today you are drinking milk. My friends, please understand, all these buffaloes and cows are drugged with lot of hormones. And you can see males are turning into female and female are turning more into males. This is all effect of hormones. Please understand this. What is required is a very simple, we have simple homeopathic medicine which can help veterinary, which can help the cow and buffaloes to deliver more milk. No side effects, no complications. Okay, so it is very easy to implement these things even in villages. How? Very simple, you can see. We take up, he said, also said the, at the urban level also we can take it. Exam fear. You have the options here. Sudden or a regular or nervous before exams and forgets everything before exam. So we can take not only the rural population, but also we can treat the urban. And you can have a very simple medicine. And it is a natural element occurring which has no side effects. Or you can have the sty, some acute condition, which can come first time or repeatedly, left eye, right eye, and there is a remedy. Suppose if the person is in the village, it could be child who is teething, can be beautifully treated without any complication and without any side effects. Now this is possible, and how does the model work? I'll share, go deeper. The first level, the health worker, is given just a mobile unit. So it can be a simple mobile unit with which the health worker go, and it is in multiple languages. Okay, very simple. It is in multiple languages. It could be in Gujarati, Marathi, all the 15 or 17 Indian recognized languages. It can be given. Now the patients who gets responded within 3 days need not be going to the next unit. But the patients who do not respond goes to the sub-center or goes to PHC or CHC. Now there the patient is treated, and the patients, some of this, say 80% of the patients will respond. Now those who do not respond, only 10 to 20% will get filtered to the city or village level hospital. So what will happen? The load on the village and hospitals will be much less. And what will happen next? Okay, taluka level or a district level or a state hospital. So filtering will keep on happening. By the time it comes to the state level hospital, it will be only 1 or 2% of them. And then by the time it goes to the headquarters, or mainly if it goes, what we require, ultimately, our super speciality hospital. So if the patients do not respond, so filtering will happen so beautifully. Finally, only 0.001% who require super speciality will be pressed. Just imagine, you know, hundreds of thousands of people not required. Filter it down. Another most important thing, it's very interesting to see this. This project has been implemented in 11 rural places in Tripura with excellent results. We are implementing the similar project also in Orissa. And Jammu Kashmir, Punjab government, even Meghalaya, Haryana have invited us to take this project further. So I have explained you details, what are the basic requirements. I'll not repeat it. We can have the applications ready in all the Indian languages. You know, what are the challenges? Simple. We have, as I have said, we can have acute module which would cover cough, cold, fever, diarrhea, something like 30-40 conditions. Pediatric module which will cover another 30 conditions. Geriatric module, eye, respiratory, ENT modules, which will work beautifully and give the results. We can have veterinary modules which will treat hundreds of such conditions for cats, dogs, pets, fishes. It is possible. And agrohomeopathy. Just imagine the kind of chemicals which are put in our food, it is amazing. If you call any of the person from UK, if he tastes your blood, he'll be able to find at least 100 different chemicals which should not be going in our system. Why? Because so much of pesticides, so much of chemicals are absolutely without any discretion put on all the food which we receive today. So this can, agro-homeopathy can help in creating better quality products, and trust me, this food will be of much, much better and much healthier for all of us. Conclusion. We talk of pilot projects. We have already done it. Now, we have a model which is cost effective, which is affordable, and which works. We are open to anybody who is working in this direction and who needs our help. Even we have a complete patient management module which works in all the languages, and we have implemented that. So we have a solution which is affordable, cost effective, gentle, which delivers result and works also as a preventive solution and easily scalable. I am thankful to you, Sir Chairman, and my friends, for giving me time, and I am thankful to Shelley, the lady who has been pursuing me since last so many days. Okay? And I'm thankful to the organizers.